this video, we will be showing you example of how to recover deleted data in SQL Server. Open SQL Server Management Studio on your computer. SQL Server environment is a must if you want to export into SQL Server database. Then right-click and select the Run as Administrator option. In this example, SQL Server 2014 version is installed. Now connect to server by entering the server name and choose Windows Authentication from the drop-down. Then click Connect button. Now you can see the Object Explorer window on the left. If it is not connected, click on the Connect button. Select the Databases option and select the desired database. Then right-click and select the Properties option. Now you can see the Database Properties window on the right. Now select Options. After that, from the Recovery Model drop-down, select Simple option. Then click OK. After that, click Desired Database and select the Required Table option. Then click on the Browse button on top. Now select the file and click Open. Now you can see a window opens on the right with details of the chosen table. Now choose the Select From option. Then click Execute button on the top navigation menu. Now below you can see the complete table data. Now for example, let's delete a table containing user data. You have to select the Delete From option. Then click Execute button on the top navigation menu. Now you can see the message below. Now let's choose the Select From option and click Execute button. You can see the data tables will appear below, and you can see the changes after deleting the table. Now let's see how to recover deleted data using SysTools SQL Log Analyzer tool. After installation, run the software on your computer. In the home screen, you will find user-friendly navigation options. Click Open button on top. A small window opens with advanced options. You can see the online database and offline database options. In this example, let's choose the online database option. In the live database option, you have to enter the server name in the field. After that, in the authentication field, select the Windows authentication option. Then choose the desired database from the drop-down option. Then click OK. The files will be scanned. After the scanning completes, click OK. Now you can see the tables from the selected database will appear on the left. You can click on the desired table to preview its records. Then on the right side, you can see all the transaction details, login name, time, transaction name, etc. from the chosen file. Here you can see the transaction details of the previously deleted file. Selecting the file will show all the details below. Now check the desired table and click on Export button on top. Now you can see different export options here. SQL Server Database option is selected by default. Then comes the SQL Server Compatible SQL Scripts option to save files as server compatible scripts. Then comes the CSV option. This option lets you export the log file into CSV format. Now, for example, let's select the SQL Server Database option. Below, you can see the Create Destination Database option. Selecting this option will export your data into a new database. After that, you have to enter the database credentials like server name and database name, etc. Below, you can see options like Insert, Update, and Delete options to read and analyze all transactions. Selecting the Insert checkbox will export all the inserted data, and choosing the Update option will export all the updated data. Then selecting the delete option will export all the deleted data. Now let's select the delete option in our example to recover the deleted data. The apply date filter checkbox option will let you filter data according to the selected date range. You can select the dates from the drop-down option. Click Export button after making the selections. After the export process completes, click OK button. Now, if you want to save the export report in a CSV file, click Yes. After that, select the folder you want to save the export report and click OK. Now let's check out the output files in SQL Server Management Studio. From the Object Explorer window, select the Databases option, then right-click and click Refresh button. Now you can see the exported database here. Then from the drop-down option on top, select the exported database. Then selecting the Table option will show the table details. Now choose the Select From option by cursor select, and then click Execute button on top. Below you can see the recovered data table with all the details. The files had been recovered successfully. You can follow the same steps to recover your deleted data. And that's it. Hope you enjoyed the video. Log on to the given product page for more details and purchasing the product. For any query, mail us to support@systoolsgroup.com. Thank you for watching.